朋友们，大家好，欢迎来到瑞视频，我是 Jennifer。美国少数族裔媒体服务中心举办线上研讨会，下面请看美国新闻速递的报道。
Week. Well, we learned something really important, which is that the nation continues to become more diverse. I am showing you here a presentation of the data in the way that we have traditionally looked at the question of race and ethnicity, from Census Bureau data. These are mutually exclusive groups of Americans, in other words, white non-Hispanic, black non-Hispanic, Asian non-Hispanic, other groups that are non-Hispanic, and then Hispanic as a separate group. And you can see that doing the analysis this way, the nation has changed and steadily changed over the course of the last 5 decades. What's interesting here is that today, in 2020, I should say in 2020, the Census Bureau counted that white Americans, non-Hispanic white Americans, single race, made up 58% of the nation's population. That is the lowest share that we've seen for white non-Hispanics in the United States ever. And so it's important to keep in mind that when people are talking about this decline in the share white, this is the big number that people are discussing.
I'm here to talk about redistricting. And American democracy is built on the principle that all people receive equal representation in the U.S. House of Representatives, in their state's legislature, and in local government, things like city council, county commission, and school boards. What this means in practice is that all districts have to have roughly the same number of people. And because the population changes, not just in total number, but also in the distribution of the population, as Mark just showed, district boundaries have to be periodically adjusted in order to comply with this equal representation principle.
Nothing is more fundamental to American democracy than the freedom and right to vote. But right now, our democracy is in peril. And unless we take immediate and direct action, we will lose it. To fully protect against racial discrimination at the ballot box and to ensure that every voice and vote count, Congress must pass the John Lewis Voting Rights Advancement Act and the For the People Act.